Welcome back, my friends, to another episode of Dominions 5. In this Let's Play series, we are playing Middle-aged Mictlan, so let's continue from where we left off. Remember, we have some house rules on effect, so check the description for a little bit more detail. We are on a little bit of pressure. Let's see the moves from our enemies this turn. We are at war with Oceania and we are at war with Marignan. It's early in the game, so no big tricks on our sleeve, and it's a matter of numbers and being at war with two nations at the same time, and they have a little bit more bonuses because of the difficulty settings of the AI. It's not going to be easy, but we are going to do our best. So let me just show you what we are going to do this turn. First off, magic wise, one of our possible means of stabilizing the map, it's go to construction level 6. Very nice items that we can forge over there, and then conjuration level 6 for some summonings, commanders that we can give the items and make some sort of tug to help us out in the battles. It's one of the options. Let's see how that goes. We'll need to buy some time so that we can reach these desired goals, but we'll see it in each turn how we are doing. Movement wise, we are trying to take back this province over here. I'm moving several armies here, just again to make a little bit bigger army, and then use it to try to stabilize this region. I don't know the full extent of the Marignan nation and the size of their armies, and even if they are at war with anyone else. But for this turn, I don't see anything that worries me except this army here. So we'll see how that goes. The rest of the movements, site searching. We need the gems to get the spell, to forge the item. So we are trying to increase our site searching, and I'm moving this army here back. We conquered this province again from Oceania, and I'm moving them back. I'm not overly concerned with Oceania. They are a water nation. Their options to attack inland are a little bit limited, but with all of the pressure of Marignan, I really don't want to move all of my armies or most of my armies over here and then expose all of this side to Marignan. So even if I could try to push a little bit into Oceania provinces, I'm being a little bit more careful and try to concentrate my armies over here where I can reassemble them and reposition them if some new threat happens to arrive. So that's the main goal over here. Recruitment wise, four castles, four recruitments over here. One Mictlan priest and eagle warriors. I can remove that one. Well, I can leave it. Capital. We'll get another high priest and more sun warriors over here. More eagle warriors and another Mictlan priest. And on the top, our new castle. We are going to recruit a Mictlan priest and more eagle warriors. So that's pretty much it. Let's check nation overview. Now I'm forging a couple of items, so we'll see them over here. The three first items that I'm going to forge, it's Amulet of Anti-Magic, Ring of Regeneration, a Frostbrand, and I'm casting the summon spell Jade Serpent. It's exclusive to Mictlan, and I do not know what kind of unit we are going to get, so we'll check that next turn. A couple of hiding and defending units. These commanders are waiting for troops to ferry to other provinces, and my few scouts, they are well positioned, so I'm not going to move. I have one here for example, another over here, so I will keep them near my borders. Other over here, So they are keeping an eye out a little bit outside my borders. If I have some time and money, I'll recruit some more and then we'll expand a little bit our scout network. But for now, they are just to check army movements and to see if there are any battles nearby our borders, which battles that do not involve us directly. It's a little bit help. It helps greatly to know if our enemies are at war with other nations. So, n enough talking. Finish off the turn, shall we? And let's see the results of our battles. Lots of battles going on, so we are sure that we are not the only ones that are at war. So we were attacked two times by Marignan and we attacked one time. Let's see the battle at Land's End. It was to be expected. These guys are going to move into our province where we have our throne. I don't know if we can defend it easily, but we'll see. We'll lose pretty much this province. Lots of cavalry, so we lost this one. Well, we killed one knight, so that was not all horrible. And second battle, we attacked at Might Marsh. Let me see. A nice army and just province defense, so that should be easy enough. A little bit fast. And let's see our flying units taking care of the commanders. And we are done over here. We lost 4 Eagle Warriors and 3 Jaguars, and that was pretty much it. Battle at Livenmark. Let's see. They attacked two different sites, and in this case, just province defense. So do not expect to be able to withstand their attack. Lost very easily, and we killed just two units from Marignan. Unexpected event plus 2 air gems. That's nice, and we have our Jade Serpent and no magical sites. So yeah, this was to be expected. It was going to be very difficult to maintain this kind of difficult positioning here. It overlaps on the top, so we'll see. We won this one. At least now we have a nice strong army here that we can move back over here, hopefully holding out to build our fortification over here. Hopefully that's my short-term goal. Let's see if we can do it. Let me just quickly check the borders. We know that Oceania are at war with Eriu, so that's good. That's something that will keep them occupied. And since they are both our neighbors, while they play with each other, they might leave me alone, and I have enough to deal with against Marignan. And I think that's pretty much it. We don't have that many visibility on the rest of the map, so that's pretty much what we can see. So guys, give me a moment and I will issue the orders for this turn and I'll be right back. So guys, pretty much the exact same turn as the turn before regarding strategy. One thing that I did not clearly mention last turn, it was I moving a couple of armies north. I have this army here moving north. Nice setup, it's going to reinforce our armies there, and another one over here. So, and in this case, a nice set of Eagle Warriors. They were sitting down here, just protecting our southern borders, but I think we cannot give the luxury of having this kind of big army just lying around without doing nothing. I might regret it later, but with the data that I have now, I need to move them north. So I'm moving both of these armies north. They will probably assemble here and then will help out stabilize, hopefully stabilize this northern part where all of the action is going on. Over here, still independent provinces, and over here we have Oceania, but they are at war with EU, so I think it's a calculated risk. I'm moving over here, and this is a little bit a riskier move, but hopefully we'll have enough troops and I can do something like this. It's pretty much the same big setup, and I can move you out. You can go and over here to research. I don't need you going with the troops. That's pretty much the difference, and that's it. Okay, hopefully we can take it back, and well, think again. I'm going to move him also because he's going to be the guy that's going to start building the fortification if we have enough money. That's it. A lot of sight searching going around over here. I'm not going to make any more magical items this turn, and I'm just going to show you guys the Jade Serpent that we can get for 5 water gems. He's sacred, amphibian, standard, so if we include him in the squad, the other units are going to get a moral bonus, and it's cold blood, it's swimming, forest survival, and the usual stuff. One, I think, mediocre attack, venomous fangs, very low length, protection wise it's good, very nice hit points, 62, nice attack skill, not so good defense skill, but okay, we are going to probably not right now, but get a couple of more of these serpents to see if they are any good in combat. But we got one, but I'm going to save a little bit my water gems because I think the bottle of living water, it's equipment level 6. Let me make sure it is. It should be level 6 since it's not available right now. It gives you a water elemental at the beginning of each battle, and I think that's pretty much something that I'm going to start forging to use in battle. I think it's a better use of my gems. But that's it. Okay, regarding moves, nothing else. Army is moving forward. A little bit of sight searching. This army is going to go back here. Probably will strike one of these provinces next turn or reinforce this army here. We'll see that in the next turn, and I'm moving my armies north. Hopefully, if we don't get any big surprises, we might be stabilizing the region on the next couple of turns. And I'm saying that before Marignan arrives with 2 huge armies over here and wrecks my plans. But if that does not happen, we might be able to stabilize a little bit this region over here. So quickly check nation overview, but I don't think there is nothing special to see here. Just a matter of you guys, if you want some detail on some units, you can pause the video and see what the unit is doing, but that's pretty much it. Some commanders defending and some scouts, they are hiding because they are well positioned. So let's finish off the turn, shall we, and see what happens. Hopefully it happens good things to us. Lots of battles going on, and okay, checking at the battles, I don't think everything went in our favor. We were attacked at Pirenia. Let's see over here. Okay, now we should be chasing this army all over the place. That's what's going to happen. And we lost this province at Pirenia. We lost it and just killed a couple of units. At Validor, we were also attacked by Marignan. smallish army, but we don't have any kind of province defense to speak of, so I don't expect big results. Yeah, we are already fleeing, so we were killed by cavalry units, and we did not kill a single one. We were attacked by Etzrerim Clevur by Oceania. More cavalry, the bane of our turns. And we are routed. Again, we did not manage to kill a single unit from our enemies, and our own battle, we attacked at Livermark. Should just catch province defense, right? Yeah, just province defense, because the army that was here attacked somewhere else. So it's going to be the cat and mouse game to try to catch that army. Easy enough for us, but not a very good turn for us. We lost 3 and 1-1. We found a magical site, two magical sites, Might Marsh and Black Marshes. Let's see this one, Might and Howling Gorge, one air and Black Marshes, Labyrinth of Skulls, which is one death gem per turn. So everything around here, it's mixed. Some units going to some place and other units going to another. At least I don't see. Yeah, they return. They have retreated, so they are not going to get us our throne, at least not for now. So that's a good thing, and we have this army to quell. We were expecting to meet him over here, but we will be hunting this army all over the place. Let me see over here. Yeah, we lost this one. It was a little bit to be expected at Validor, but it's not that big army, and we might. I need to think a little bit on what to do. And we lost also over here against Oceania. So that's pretty much it. At least my armies are going forward, and I don't know if I'm going to leave this one here for one turn. I cannot, because I don't have anyone to bless the army, and these guys without blessing, they are just random units. Well, guys, but it's a little bit to think about, so give me a moment and I will issue the orders for this turn. So guys, let me just show you what we are going to do this turn. I'm going to move one army out of this castle and try to take out or to get back this province over here. This army over here is going to try to intercept this one with the help of this one here. At least I'll be able to combine both armies over here. And I'm moving out one army from here to over here. So that's our three main army moves for next turn. Hopefully, I don't know if Oceania is going to attack here or not, but we are going to defend and then probably push out again. And in this case, try to buy us some time by maintaining Marignan occupied over here by getting this province. And it's a farmland, so we get a lot of income if we own it, because we have an adjacent fortification. So let's see if we can take it back. Army-wise, that's pretty much it. Recruitment exactly the same as last turn, and a lot of movements over here with my mages to site search a lot, try to get all of the provinces searched with the path that we know, and we know a lot. We have some Rainbow Bay mages, so let's take advantages of that and find all of those sites. Magic wise, I don't know if you remember, but at the beginning of the episode, I think our research did not reach even 300, and now it's 423. One of the good things of Mictlan, it's that we have very cheap and very efficient mages, and with our scales, I think it's plus to magic, it even helps us a little bit further. So let's try to overcome our deficits regarding quality of the units in combat by increasing our research. So let's see if that works out. It works at the long run, but we need to survive the short term. So that's the main difficulty over here. So anything else worth mentioning for this turn? I think it's pretty much the same. Moving the armies over here to defensive positions and try to take out this Marignan army. We don't have enough treasury to start building the fortification here, and I wouldn't start it unless I'm a little bit sure that we can hold out the province for enough time to completely build the fortification, at least in theory. We can get always some unexpected things in dominions. It's dominions. A lot of strange things happen. But now I don't think it's the wise choice to start building the fortification right now over here. We have two armies adjacent to the province, and I really don't know if there are any more. So let's try to take out this army, and then with the reinforcements, if I don't see that big of a movement over here, we might start building the fortification over there. But that's it. Dacian overview. Quickly check. Nothing special. A lot of people researching and site searching. And I'm trying the True Shot Longbow. It's a very cheap item. You need 5 air gems to forge it, and it's a nice bow to give to some of my commanders that are doing nothing in the battlefield. Let's see if it works out or not. It's a little bit of a something a little bit more RPG, like using my commanders with very nice magical items. I don't know if they are really worth it, and if we could not use that 5 air gems in a more useful way, like for instance the howl wheel that will even further us our research. But I will forge a couple of true shot longbows, and we'll keep watching our commanders to see if it makes that big of a difference in combat. Nothing else to see. We are ready to finish off the turn. Hopefully it's going to be a little bit better than last turn, where we lost four battles, we lost 3 and 1-1. Let's see. I'm not that optimist, but we'll see. Well, at least just 2 battles, and it was us that initiated the battle, so let's see. First one, we are trying to get the army from Marignan, and we managed to succeed. We caught it. So I think we have enough troops to handle. Yes, we do, and our flying units dispatched all of Marignan troops. It was this one. We lost 5 Eagle Warriors, a couple of slaves, and a couple of warriors, and we don't have that many good units, but at least since we fly when blessed, the good thing is all of the units get killed of our enemies, and none of them are able to retreat. So usually in the regular combat, half of the army is going to flee, and 25 to 30%, we can gather it up, and they will fight again. In this case, we are pretty much sure that no one leaves the battlefield alive. If we win the battle, of course. In the battle at the Validor, we attacked Marignan again. Let's see. In this case, I'm a little bit concerned. No, the army that was there, it's not anymore, so it's a very small province defense. I don't mind. In this case, it was not that important to catch the army. It was more important to get to the province back. So that was, and if we don't get losses, or if the losses are very few, I'm happy with it. And unexpected event, gold, thank you very much. That's the main purpose of selecting luck scales. And we got a rawhide shield. I don't know what kind of shield it is, but I don't think it's good. But the gold, it's very important again for building my fortification. So quickly check. Quickly check the borders. These guys are occupied with Oceania, which helps me a lot. And we over here, I do not see any kind of big Marinho army around. Let me move back again. This small to mid size army from Marinho over here, but I don't, I'm not too concerned. We stabilized over here. Fortification here, and I might get and kick out Oceania from all of these positions. The only thing that's it's keeping me from doing so, it will open up us against the against or against or open up our borders to Abyssia. And let me check the notes. Abyssia are they are teaming up with the armor, and for now we are not at war with them, so that's nice. But if it was, we are at war with Marignon. If getting these provinces will open up the borders against Caelum, it would not be a good choice because they would also attack us. So that's nice. We might get try to get these Oceania provinces for ourselves. But the main concern I think is consistency and to stabilize our defense here, and then it will be a little bit more easy to move forward. So let's not expose ourselves in some place just for the sake of getting more provinces, and then we'll regret because we'll extend ourselves more than we can defend ourselves. So let's be wise. Well, guys, but I was not too happy about how the episode was going. I like the episodes. I like a good challenge, and it was a good challenge. But we were under a lot of pressure. But this last turn, it cheered me up. It was a very good turn for us. Not too much pressure. We won our battles. We did not lose a single one. So it's a little bit a good thing to end on a high note. I hope you are enjoying this Let's Play series of Midland with these crazy house rules that I have decided to play with. Let me know in the comments what are your thoughts, and I hope to see you all in the next episode. Until then, thank you.